Hello, on behalf of the Rochester Chamber Music Society and the Artaria String Quartet, I'd like to welcome you to this evening's concert. We just heard the Punto movement from the Danzas de Panama by William Grant Still, written in 1946. A little bit about William Grant Still, he's considered the dean of Afro-American composers in this country. He lived from 1895 to 1978, and was quite a prolific composer, studying at Oberlin Conservatory and working with Edgar Varèse, among others. Punto is taken from this work, and it is one of the dance movements, five dance movements based on African rhythms and as well as Central American and Latin dances. The punto, punto means pointed, and it reflects the pointing of the toes. It's a very classic dance, especially in Panama and as well as Colombia. Artaria has really enjoyed performing this piece this summer, as along with the other four movements of the work. It's lovely. The dances are quite lovely and have been enjoyed by our audiences outdoors throughout the Twin Cities. So we're happy to be able to play this movement for you as an introduction to the piece. The piece that we're going to turn to next is written by the great master himself, Ludwig van Beethoven. Around the age of 28, shortly after arriving in Vienna, Beethoven threw himself into the study of the string quartet, studying those written prior to that by Haydn, who established the genre, and then his follower, Mozart. He also studied Bach's counterpoint, and with a bit of trial and error, he turned out his first six quartets, the Opus 18 quartets, which he dedicated to Haydn himself. The number one in F major actually was the second of the quartets of that Opus 18, but was geniusly published as the first in the group. It shows an astonishing mastery of the language of Haydn and Mozart, and a language that Beethoven uses to express his own personality and to demonstrate his own innovative creativity. The four movements of this quartet are the Allegro con brio, which is a brisk, energetic movement that highlights a fully independent cello part, which he inherited from Haydn. followed by the centerpiece of the whole quartet. It's epic, the Adagio Affettuoso ed Appassionato, which historians everywhere agree it was based on the tomb scene from Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet, and it's written with an incredible emotional intensity, and that was shocking for its time. Followed by a scherzo marked Allegro Molto, and you can only imagine that it's a very driving scherzo. The scherzo was derived from the minuet, which was a much softer movement, a slower paced movement in three. But Haydn had already started speeding it up as a joke to his patrons, and Beethoven just simply took it further. The quartet ends with a dazzling allegro in 2/4 time. Now, the first three movements are written in three, a pulse, a meter of three, and the last one is finally back into a 2/4 time. This piece is a beautiful piece, and it opens one of the greatest cycles of music in the entire Western icon. I tell you, the 16 quartets of Beethoven are each and every one of them a masterpiece, and this one really sets the tone for the whole thing. I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you.